This is House of Machismo.
What's up, everyone? This is Marty bringing you House of Machismo. We're back. We're not live, but we're pre-recorded. That's okay. It's a nice Sunday morning, but you don't know that. Anyways, I'm Marty, and there's no Luis, but we'll skip him. And we have the awesome K-Rod here next to me.
Hey, everybody. How y'all doing? Hey, Luis, say something.
Say something, Luis.
Oh, he's not here.
Oh, wait, he's not here today. Oh, well,
he's too busy.
Is this going to be me and K-Rod today? So,
It's going to be a great show.
Oh, my God. It's going to be such an awesome show.
We're going to do better than ever.
Well, it's going to be an awesome show because there'll be less criticism and just a little less patriotism. I mean, patriotism is awesome, but not when you bring it at 250%. So you'll kind of notice a big difference. That's right. So I'm Marty. This is K-Rod. And this is House of Machismo. So how you doing today, Keith?
I'm pretty good. I'm full.
Oh, yeah.
You fed me.
That's right. I feed everybody who comes on here.
Yes.
No, I mean, who comes on the show. Like, wait, who is on the show?
That sounded
It was a big cleanup.
That sounded awesome.
This is very difficult.
Those eggs were good.
They were.
And whatever you put on it.
It's turkey sausage.
Turkey sausage.
Yeah, I don't think it's any healthier for you, but it sounds healthy. Turkey sounds healthy.
It does.
Yeah. So.
And then I drowned it in ketchup.
Right, so you couldn't taste anything.
I couldn't taste nothing, so just eating ketchup.
That's right. So anyway, so as you kind of noticed, we're a little quiet today. There's no Luis on the show today. He had something better to do, apparently.
Like racing.
Yeah. Well, he's not racing. He says it's not a race. It's just a bunch of dudes who just drive around in a circle. Like, there's no winner or anything like that.
That's what a loser says.
Right.
Sorry, Luis.
Whoever comes, he always comes last.
If you ain't first, you're last.
That's right. Well, he came at least three times first, I guess. He has 2-3 kids or something like that.
Oh.
Right.
I get it.
Yeah. So Luis isn't here. K-Rod's here. So it's going to be kind of an interesting show that we're going to bring you today. Mm-hmm. All packed of all sorts of fun and things.
And a musical.
There's no musical.
Oh, damn it.
Sorry.
Never mind, people.
Maybe one musical.
We're disappointed.
Maybe one music. Yes. Maybe one song.
Yay.
We'll see. Yay. So anyway, because Keith loves to sing. He's not good at it, but he loves to sing.
Good.
And he never remembers the lyrics either.
I don't.
He doesn't, even though he's heard these songs many times.
I know.
Huh? He doesn't remember the lyrics to them.
It's okay.
Yes. So anyway.
Because you'll sing along with me, guys.
Right. No, they won't.
Yes,
in fact, we'll lose one more view, one more listener.
So back to two.
We'll be down to two.
You lost me. No.
Right. And then you're not going to be here next week.
I am not.
You're going to be on vacation.
I am.
And then this is going to be me and Luis.
And that's going to be a boring show.
No. How dare you leave me alone with Luis?
Have fun.
It's like, we're going to be talking about America.
America.
That's right.
Second Amendment.
Yeah. You know,
I bet you're going to be like, Marty, let's go shooting.
Actually, that's not a bad idea. I wouldn't mind doing a little target practicing. A little redneck target practicing. I mean, not targeting rednecks, but you know how they are. They're like, woo-wee, let's shoot them tin cans.
Get her, dude.
Yeah, exactly. Like, let's shoot them tin cans. I had those tin cans ever since I was a little boy.
What if you talk like that the whole time?
No, I think that'd be very annoying.
We'll get audience.
By the way, we do have a little bit of Luis here with us. I pre-thought about this. Because I thought that this would be interesting not having him here, because he's always chiming in like on shit that he doesn't know anything about. You know, so I kind of thought that like randomly, like while we're talking or something, we'll just kind of randomly hear shit like,
"You're disrespecting America."
like shit like that. I think that'd be kind of awesome. It's like as if he's already here.
Basically, we don't need Luis.
We don't need him. We just, you know, we can do shit like his grunts.
Jesus.
You know how he grunts? See? Just like that. Exactly.
This is awesome.
You know, and then
Luis, you have been replaced by a computer.
I know, right? It's like his job isn't really secure. Not even his plumbing job. I mean, pretty soon there'll be robots doing that. Pretty soon.
Wait, are the robots gonna have a plumber crack?
I was just about to bring that up. They will have a plumber's crack.
That is awesome.
That's how the public will trust our new robot overlord master plumbers.
Nice.
That's right, by having the robotic cracks.
It's not trust until you see the crack.
Exactly.
You know? But and, are they going to say, oh, I feel a breeze up my crack?
Yes, because you can program it too. You know, they'll be able to be done in half the time also. Because, you know, because the less scratching and all that. Much more precise because they know actually how to measure. Mm. You know, as opposed to most plumbers who are like, they just kind of guess it. It's like, it's about that long.
But how will they do porn?
Efficiently. Very efficiently.
You know how they make porn?
I mean, like, they are machines.
I'm here to lay down the pipe.
Yes, except it would be more like, I am here to lay down the pipe.
And then he kills her. Because he's a robot.
That's right, and he's very powerful.
Powerful.
Like a lot of pushing. Oh, yeah. Or just ruins her for all human men. Or something, I don't know. Or him, I don't judge. So anyway, so and in case we get to talking about like Spanish shit or something.
Sorry, no hablo español.
See? So we got it covered here.
Luisa, you've been replaced. Absolutely. You are the weakest link.
You know what? Goodbye. What the funny thing is that the last time we were here, he was talking about, hey, what time are you going to go see the movie, this movie? Mm-hmm. And like I said, he was kind of a tease. You know, like I told him, I don't know yet, but he's like, I'm so bored around my house and all that. So I said, well, let's go to a movie. He's like, well, I don't feel like going. You know, but I'm like, but what time are you going to go? So then yesterday, I'm out and about doing stuff, and then I get a message from him saying, hey, so did you want to go see that Godzilla movie? Mm-hmm. And I'm like, oh, that's so, I was like, oh, I love the movie. Godzilla was awesome. He's like, oh, so you already saw it. I was like, yes. It's like, oh, okay, well, there was a movie starting like around 1:05 or something that he was going to go see. And I'm thinking, you know, this would probably, this is like his opportunity. Like he's inviting me.
Yeah.
And I let him down. So I'm thinking like the next time, like no invitation. It's like
you lost your chance.
As I lost my chance.
To hang out with him.
Going to see a movie. Yeah.
Sitting next to each other eating popcorn.
Oh, I don't eat popcorn.
Eating hot dog. Or eat a pickle like I do.
I don't eat anything at the movies. It's really expensive.
It is.
I eat.
I wouldn't know because you pay for me.
That's right. Yeah. Well, I know. It's really expensive. Like, Marty, can I have two hot dogs? I'm like, what? Why? Okay, I guess.
One hot dog.
I'm like, oh, God, I guess that leaves nothing for me. Yeah. It's all right.
You could just watch me eat it.
That's right.
Yes.
It smells like
you always
feet.
Do.
Well, you also smell like feet.
That was baby hands' feet.
A little bit. It was a hot dog a little bit, that but for the majority, yeah, it was pretty rancid, wasn't it? It was very rancid.
It did have a little funny taste to it, but I kept going like a champ.
Right. You're like, oh, this hot dog. It's like, why does it smell so much, but it's so good?
It tastes so
little good. Did we know that a friend that we went along had taken off his shoes during the movie and really stank up the theater.
And you thought it was my hot dog.
I thought it was your hot dog even after it was all gone.
Yes.
That's right. So, sorry.
Thanks.
I apologize.
Throughout the whole movie, you kept saying, Keith, what?
What the fuck is with your hot dog? It must be your hot dog
and
breath.
And I kept saying, it wasn't me. It's not my hot dog.
it's like your hot dog breath, man.
Hell no.
It's like, close your mouth.
And then I started eating my pickle and kept taking pictures.
I did.
You always
take
pictures.
But that was after the movie. I went back to my place.
What?
What? You don't remember that.
You roofied me.
No wonder
you gave me that drink.
You drank it yourself. It's like, ooh, you put your own roofie inside of it. It's better someone not take advantage of me.
That's funny.
Yeah, that's you doing that.
Shut up.
Yeah. So anyway, a couple of weeks ago, well, your bike was broken for a little bit.
Yes.
Wasn't it?
It was.
And then you didn't know what was wrong with it.
No.
You're like, it's made in China. What else do you want? You know,
it's supposed to be great.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. So anyway,
everything's better over there.
So I remember you were leaving my house in your motorcycle. Do you like to call it a motorcycle? Is it a motorbike? Is it a bike? What do you like to call it?
A motorcycle.
Piece of shit. I don't know.
Not anymore.
Motorcycle, right?
Motorcycle.
Okay. So you were leaving my house, mm-hmm. and Luis was pulling off, driving off. Mm-hmm. And then he stopped as soon as he heard your motorcycle cry. Mm-hmm. He came back. He put his truck in reverse and came back. Completely ignored you. Uh-huh. You're like, hey, oh, so my bike is like, he just ignored you and went straight to the bike. And he's all like, baby, what did he do to you? This ain't America. This isn't my America. You know? Oh, my God. Oh, you bastard. Remember, he took a swing at you. That's what happened in my head. Maybe not in real life. But in my head, he took a couple of swings at you.
And he missed.
And he missed.
Because I'm
And then he spun around to a circle. And
what
got,
the?
Got dizzy. He got dizzy or something. I don't know. He doesn't strike me as a fighter.
He's a shooter.
Yeah. Yeah, I get that. But he doesn't, you know, news to people, he doesn't actually carry his guns with him. But
yes,
anyway.
He does.
So anyway.
Make him sound cool.
Oh. Oh. Now you're disrespecting America.
Yeah.
There you go. See?
There you okay. go.
That's how it works. Wow, we really don't need him on here.
We could talk for him.
That's right. Yeah, he'd just be over there taking another survey on his phone. Yeah. So it was then something happened to your bike. You're able to ride it home, which is fine. It was just the engine was shaking a lot.
Yes.
As bike's yeah. engines shake.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
But anyway.
Nah, it was...
But yeah, here, talk to me in your best Luis impression about what was wrong with your bike.
Yeah, so Second Amendment, I was with my son at his house.
And after every sentence, you have to say Second Amendment. Come on.
I was leaving my son's house with his mom. Second Amendment, yeah. Then I was riding, and then I felt something hit my leg. Second Amendment, yeah. And then I didn't think nothing much of it. I was at a red light. Second Amendment.
But let me ask you this. So you are concerned about the Second Amendment, correct?
I am.
Okay.
Yeah.
But also your bike.
And my bike.
Yeah.
That's Merc. Everybody needs a bike.
And then it just stopped working.
And then the light turned green and the gears wouldn't go. So I was just stuck. Second Amendment. Yeah. And then I was like, wait, I'm a man. I know what to do. Second Amendment. Yeah.
You're all like, you're like this. Hold on. You're like, Laura? Laura, listen, can you, look, my bike broke, the bike that you bought me.
Why do I sound like
for
that?
For my birthday.
Wait, I bought that for my birthday.
Oh, Laura, this is your fault somehow. could you come and pick me up and give me a ride? My little bike broke. Can you help me? Yes, I know it was made in China, yada, yada. It's all right. It's inferior products. I get it, but I need a ride home. Okay, love you, bye-bye.
Whoa.
It went down exactly like that, right?
No.
Oh.
Second Amendment, yeah.
Okay.
Actually, I did call her. That was funny. That's why I laughed. And then I called her, and the whole hour and 3 minutes and 32 seconds that I had to push that thing to my house, I was on the phone with her the whole time.
Okay, so then Laura, so then obviously the conversation must have been going like this, like, Keith, you know what? I am too busy right now to come pick you up. I got shit to do. All right? I got bills to pay. I got a child to care for. You want to push your bike home? Then you go ahead and do it. Because I can't come over and pick you up right now. Okay?
Yes. All
right. Thank you. Love you. Bye. It was like that, right?
The L.
You can tell who the wears
L
the wear, pants.
The L wear has been thrown around too much.
Oh, really? Oh.
But it was funny. Anyways.
So you had to push the damn bike home.
I could have sworn she said, hey, look at the bright side. You're getting muscles out of this. I'm like, thanks. What the hell? Yeah.
Okay. So,
oh, my God.
So it went more like, oh, my God, Keith. Well, I mean, look at it this way. At least you're getting muscles out of it. Kind of like our 22-year-old neighbor over here. Josue.
He's fucking young. What
like Josue. Yeah. Maybe you get like a muscle. Or something. Or something.
Oh, that's funny.
It's like, I really don't know how you developed that dad bod overnight. But, so what about Josue? Love you, bye. Kind of like that.
Funny thing is, yeah. She actually did tell me about her neighbor that was hot, that had muscles.
Oh, wow.
They used to live there years ago. That's funny. And he was mixed, I think.
I don't know what happened. It wasn't even one night of passion, and he's gone. So anyway, so how you doing today, Keith?
I'm struggling pushing this bike.
Okay, but tell me, what did you think of Josue when you saw him?
He was actually sexy.
That's what I knew. I knew it. Okay, love you. Bye.
That's funny.
Kind of like that, right?
Exactly like that.
Okay. I just have a way of interpreting these things. Yes, okay.
It's like you can tell.
So it took you over an hour to push your bike. How many blocks? Like two?
No, it was, fuck, it was a long way. And the thing that pissed me off more, that
Laura really didn't want to come pick you up? Go
no,
on.
Actually, she kept saying, I'm going to go get you. I'm like, no. But, and, oh my God.
ask Josue to come pick you up if you want. I mean, he doesn't live next door anymore, but you can Google him.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, no, he's
you know how many
Josues
there are?
He's a friend on my Facebook. Oh, and I have a Facebook, Keith. I didn't know if you knew that. But anyway.
I did.
But yeah, I could ask him if he can go pick you up with his strong arm.
He don't need a truck. He just picks it up.
Yeah, he'll just carry you in and your bike. And his thick arms and his also tan mocha skin.
Don't forget the thunder thighs.
And the thunder thighs as well. Anyways, love you. Bye.
I'm getting all choked up.
I can tell. It's like, so what happened after Josue picked you up?
He didn't.
Oh, he didn't. Okay.
No, that thing was pissing me off. Nobody would help. There was so many cars passing by, and it was like fucking 11 o'clock at night already.
And Barack Obama was passing by. He'd stop and help you.
He would.
He would have gotten Josue for you.
I am no Josue. I wish I could talk like
him. No, you can't.
But
It sounds more convincing over the phone. Yeah, exactly.
But, yeah, so that's what pissed me off the most, because if I would have saw somebody like that, I would do it. I will help you out. I don't know how, but I will.
God, you know what? I don't like talking about this kind of stuff, but it's kind of an interesting thing. And this is my first time ever talking about the kind of shit that I do. But yesterday, my friend and I were driving around. We were looking for garage sales, actually. No, we're not gay. Anyway.
What? What is that?
Well, that's where I bought that painting over there. It's not even a painting. It looks like a painting. But there was this dude that was walking barefoot, like on the hot concrete and stuff, like on the road, you know, and when they were doing construction, he was like walking on rocks and he was really struggling. And so I'm like, here, stop the car, dude. I'm just going to
give him my shoes.
I gave him my shoes, my Adidas shoes, my black Adidas
Why
shoes.
Why would you give your Adidas shoes I went with you to go buy?
Because I have a blue pair that matches it. Exactly.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, and it gives us a chance to go and get some more. But anyways.
I'm going
to
give you these while I buy some brand new ones.
Well, exactly. Well, the ones that I had on were black and they were kind of worn. I mean, so I'm like, oh, well, here you go.
Did him?
I don't know. if I'm walking on hot concrete with rocks, I mean, I'm going to make it fit.
Yeah.
Yeah, be like a... I don't want to be offensive. Never mind. So anyway, I gave him my shoes. And the weird part about it is that he sounded kind of weird. He's always like, thanks, I have all, I'm going uphill now. Like, seriously.
Is he a slow guy?
And then, like, I don't know, it was sweat or slobber, but whatever it is, like, landed on my hand as I was handing him the shoes. It was some sort of bodily fluid.
And it burned.
And I'm like, oh my God, that's so disgusting. But then I'm like, but here you go. Here's some shoes.
Just gave me a disease.
Yeah, good luck. And I'm like, oh my God. I'm like telling my friend, take me to get my hand washed now.
I think you were like jumping, like, I'm going to get it off.
It was like a few drops on my hand. I don't know if it came from his mouth or if it came from the sweat that was dripping off
his
head.
Disgusting.
He looked a little different. He was a white dude, kind of like a bob haircut, a little bit.
What if he was walking to his like freaking brand new Mercedes and shit and he just forgot his shoes?
Well, then he knows that there are nice people out there.
He'd probably be like, ugh, Adidas, the fuck, I wear Louis Vuitton.
On the other side of the spectrum, we went through this really nice neighborhood.
And he was there, not even the South.
No. And there were these two little girls selling lemonade. And when we drove by, I'm like, I don't want to buy lemonade from them because
they're going to be expensive here.
It was going to be very expensive. And you know what? They gave like these small little cups, like those sample cups.
It'll be $5.
And it was about little halfway fill.
Yeah.
And it was $1.
Hell.
And my friend gets out to go buy some. Like, they're like jumping up and down, like, yay, we have a customer. And I'm thinking, this is like a really bad neighborhood to be selling lemonade because it's like a rich upper middle class kind of a neighborhood to a point where the homes all have fencing around them.
Oh shit.
Yeah, it's not like a suburban kind of neighborhood. I mean, like, these people got money. And my friend's like, oh, well, they're learning a value of $1. I'm like, they're rich. Why do they need to learn it right now by doing that? No one's gonna buy anything.
Yeah.
Proof is because they were so excited when we stopped.
Mm-hmm.
And then
poor people are here.
Right. And when my friend brings me a cup of lemonade, I'm like, oh, no, like my window's open. I go, oh, I don't like lemonade. And then he's like, dude, don't say that loud. I'm like, oh, my God, I can't believe I said that out loud.
Yeah.
Like I really didn't. And I said it loud.
Yeah.
And I really, you know, I didn't want to hurt their feelings or anything. But what the hell do they care?
So you got
to live in a fucking nice house. I mean, it was huge. Yeah. And so there was no traffic. Like this isn't the kind of neighborhood where you go walk your dog.
Mm-hmm.
This is the kind of neighborhood where you come home and you close your electric gate. and you don't emerge until the next day when you go to work or go to Hawaii, wherever.
Damn.
Wherever the hell they're going to go. Uh-huh. It was a bad place to, not like dangerous, but it's just a bad spot. You know, it's like opening, like, I don't know, like, what is it? Opening like a Central Market or Whole Foods, like in the ghetto or something. It's like, uh-huh. People like to look at it, but they're not going to stop.
Yeah.
You know, but that's just my impression.
But
what?
The question is, how good was that lemonade?
I didn't drink it.
Oh, that would have been probably the best lemonade they ever had.
He said it was okay.
They probably put it in gold ice cubes.
I know, right? It's like, oh, just keep the gold. That's just an incentive.
We don't want, we have so
many. Yeah, we have so many gold nuggets. But anyway. But the little girls, they were excited, you know, that they got a customer.
When you say little girls, were they like 18?
No.
Oh, not that little. I mean, not that other little.
Not like that. They must have been like maybe 10 or 12 or something.
Well,
like
you
that.
Made their day. They probably
I didn't make their day and pay for shit.
They probably proved their parents wrong. I bet you we could sell lemonade to the poor.
Mom's like, good luck with that.
And then that's when y'all came along.
That's right. It just happened to be
and
along.
Now they got a Maserati.
Ooh, we stopped by. I mean, this is really bad for podcast, but.
Yeah, very excited there.
we stopped by this one house that looked fucking awesome. Let me see.
And why are you taking pictures of my house?
No, believe me, it is not your house.
And then you zoom in the close up in the window, it's me.
Oh, no.
Oh, shoot. What the fuck?
Isn't that a cool house? Yeah. That's like a AI house. Like there's like artificial intelligence running the shit out of that house.
But look what they drive, a Nissan Altima.
You know what? That's what my friend pointed out. I'm thinking maybe that's the person that maybe works
cleans
security.
It.
Yeah, or something. Like this the maid nice drives house. A brand new Nissan Altima.
You know, but I have seen houses like that or rich houses and their cars are like.
Look at, like, I zoomed in on their in their window.
See, I love that. That's fucking
look
awesome.
At those, look at that staircase.
I would walk bare naked up those stairs.
Oh, me too. I'd be like all naked like all the time. I don't give a shit. I'm that rich.
Yeah, make fun of my small penis, but hey, I'm yeah, here, you're out there.
Well, I would have like a pretend extension on it because they're not going to come in and talk to me. So I might as well.
And then turn to this window hard and go
right,
fly.
And it smacks the against the window.
And they get stuck. And it goes slowly down the window.
It's like, oops.
It's just. Smiling.
Oh, wait, hold on. I went to the backyard. Hold on.
What the fuck?
No, I'm kidding. No, I'm kidding.
I'm inside the house.
Yeah. It was really nice. I made
under
myself
the bed.
At home. I made myself at home.
Oh, well, we get in trouble for doing that.
What?
Try to go inside a house?
Yes.
Oh, it's called breaking an interview.
Yes. And it would be the what? The what? Oh, wait, hold on.
The what, Luis?
Do I have something with that? I don't have anything with the Second Amendment.
Damn it, Luis.
Oh, wait, there we go. The what?
You were disrespecting America.
No, I wasn't, Luis. I'm just breaking and entering.
That's right. Stupid Luis. Stupid. He doesn't even know. He doesn't even know what he's talking about. Wait, don't laugh at us. Bastard.
Even when he's not here, he laughs at
he's
us.
He's annoying even when he's not here. So anyway.
Back to the bike.
Yeah, back to the bike.
So I got home, blah, blah, blah. And then about 2 weeks ago, I told Luis about it. America. Because he knows how to fix everything.
Yeah.
And
apparently.
I told him what was wrong, and oh, I thought you muted me. I was like, how rude of you. I told him what was wrong. He said,
I pushed the wrong button.
I know. And then he was like, in my head, I was like, oh, I thought he was going to fix it. He's like, oh, I can fix it, Keith. I'm like, okay, cool. So he said, oh, we should take it to where you bought it, see if they can fix it.
And well, I'm I mean, like, he had to come and get it.
Yeah.
And he works near where you live.
Yes. But he didn't go get it. You want to go get it.
You're welcome.
Even though I just threw it in there, but
I know, right? I tipped it on its side.
I know.
How else were you supposed to do it? Which, by the way, see, I don't know shit about any of this kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And I told Luis that, yeah, it smelled like gasoline in the it was tipped over and all that. It was coming out and blah, blah, blah. He's like, well, why didn't you do the thing to the carburetor and do this and that and then choke it or something like that? I'm like,
I'll choke you, all right?
I was like, I don't know. It's like, why would I know how to do that? Because I'm a man. You know,
America.
All that. Yeah, exactly.
That's disrespecting America.
I'm like, okay, I get it. You have a small penis. Jesus.
Trying to seem tough.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
I see through him. Anyway.
But yeah, y'all picked it up, and then y'all brought it to your place, and then
I left it outside because it was stinking up my garage because it still smelled like gasoline.
And you left it in the fucking rain, but hey, at least I got a free wash.
Mm-hmm.
And they should at least throw some soap on it or some shit. Fuck.
You wash your own foreign Chinese piece of crap.
Whatever. And then, yeah, so we took it to the place with Luis. We put it in the truck instead of doing this.
Right. We were supposed to record a podcast. I'm like, let's just go get it fixed.
Let's go see what kind of fucked up shit we do. So we went over there. I started explaining it to the people, and they were charging me all this shit. I'm like, you know what? I looked at
Luis. They were charging $80
per hour.
Right.
And they were going to charge me probably for the parts. And I looked at, I was like, fuck no.
Well, the guy you were talking to looked like your fucking little brother.
He did.
I was like, holy crap. But he was a Nike guy. That's the thing. He was wearing Nike.
And I'm Adidas.
And you were wearing Adidas. Not that day, but you're Adidas kind of person. But same glasses, sleeve tattoo, same facial hair.
Who was sexier?
Well, he was. He was like way younger than you, dude.
So you like him young.
Yes, I don't know. Exactly. I don't know. I really didn't think about it.
I didn't think about it. I just took a picture of him.
Oh, he's just probably better at it than you are anyway.
Probably everybody is.
I guess he didn't have the dad bod yet.
Not yet. Just wait till he has kids.
I know, right?
Watch him have three kids.
I have four kids. I learned how to take care of myself, dude.
Fuck. Yeah. True. I eat salad.
So
I told the guy, all right, well, let me think it over. So he left with another customer. So I looked at Lisa. I'm like, can you fix this? I'll pay you. He said, I told you from the beginning I couldn't do it. I'm like, nope. You said we should bring it. Like, see what they think. So we drove like 30, 40 minutes.
He was bored. He really didn't have anything else to do.
He probably didn't want to do this that day. He probably hungover. No. So, and then we came back all the way over to his house to drop it off. And then apparently it took him 15 minutes to fix it. Because you texted me too.
It was about 10.
And then, well, Les, he said, it's done. I'm like, God damn, that was fast. Did he even do something? And it runs better than ever. So I thank you. So you're going to be my new motorcycle mechanic. Much love.
He likes doing that kind of stuff, I guess. I don't know.
Because
he'll always help out. He will always help out a motorcycle in distress.
Second Amendment.
Yeah. That's right.
Exactly. So this is a whole different thing. But since you brought up your good deed, I did one yesterday too.
I don't want to hear about it. Tell me. That's okay.
No, we're going to a party. That's why I'm dressed like this though. We're on the
because you wanted to show me what
sexy I look.
What is that? Is those parrots? What kind of parrot is that on your shirt?
I don't know. An awesome parrot.
It's called a scarlet macaw.
What?
A scarlet macaw.
I don't know what that is.
That's the type of parrot that's on your
Scarlett
shirt.
Scarlett Johansson?
No, scarlet macaw.
Oh, is that an actor?
No, it's a bird.
Oh,
yeah. Not so much an actor as it is a bird.
That'd be an awesome actor name.
How big are those birds?
Like the size of my shirt.
No, they're pretty big. They're probably, with the feathers, they're probably about this big.
Is it the same thing as the one from Lion King?
I don't know, I've never seen it.
Oh, what the fuck?
Shouldn't be. Those Scarlet Macaws live in South America.
They're pretty, aren't they?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Anyways, my good deed.
Yes, what's your good deed?
We're going on a busy street on Jupiter, driving, and all of a sudden I see a freaking basketball fly through the fucking busy street. I'm like, what the fuck? And I looked to my right, and there was a kid trying to jump the fence and get the bomb. I'm like, oh, what the fuck? No. So I literally parked and put an emergency brake, and I fucking hopped off, and I jumped out the car and ran to the other side of oncoming traffic, try to get the ball. When I'm looking back, and the dad is also struggling, trying to jump the fence. I'm like, bro, you have a little gate to open. Stop trying to look cool in front of your kid.
Were they Mexican?
Yes, they were my people.
Trying to jump the fence, huh?
We're good at it.
Yeah.
No, but
not really, if they're trying.
He was kind of struggling, so I was kind of disappointed.
Yeah.
He was probably...
He lost his skills.
He wasn't Mexican. He was a Mexican.
He can't.
Yes.
Right.
So, and then I got the ball, and then I looked at him, and he was going like, it's mine. I'm like, I know it's yours. I'm not trying to steal this ball. So I was running back. And
you should have ran into your car with it and drive off.
That would have been funny.
But then come back. And just kidding.
Just kidding. Just throw it.
Yeah.
And then I threw it like a football. And
only you would do that. Come on.
And yes, he kind of missed it, as in he didn't catch it, and it bounced back on the main street. So I was like, okay, that's your problem. So he got it, and he said, thank you. I was like, you're welcome. And then I busted a sweat, and I was tired already.
You busted a what?
A sweat.
Oh, okay.
Not a,
whoa, what's not up? A, yeah.
I wish. No, yeah. Like, I got excited. So that was my good deed.
Oh.
Well, I saved someone's life.
No, you didn't. Just gave somebody back their ball.
Whatever. I saved his life. Something could have happened.
It could have, but there was no indication that something would.
Even though I did stop traffic.
I knew a few women that could stop traffic. Like, literally, they would stop traffic.
Police officers?
No, women. Like, just walk, trying to cross the street.
You think if I cross the street, will I stop traffic?
No, you won't.
No, they won't fucking...
No, but these women, they stop traffic. Like, they stopped. Just to let them walk by.
Can we see these women?
You met them before.
Wait, can we do an experiment and let them walk while we record? So just in case,
what?
No, crossing the street.
Oh.
Just in case your thing fails, we record an accident.
I guess.
What if it was a girl driver? Oh my God. Hits her.
Oh, that bitch.
That bitch. My husband's right next to me looking at you.
I know, right? She floors it. What are you looking at? Oh my God, what are you looking at?
She's sexy, not for long.
Oh no, she's not sexy no more. Look at her on the floor. Oh, look how flat her little breasts are. Oh.
Okay, almost sounded like the girl from Family Guy.
Lemon. So anyway, well, that was cool. You got your bike fixed finally. So I know you were kind of sad about it.
I was.
And then you were sad. We were pointing out you should have gotten a better bike.
I know.
Like, no.
I almost got a bigger one.
No, you didn't.
Shut up. Yes, I did.
You looked at one and thought about getting it. Like, if I had money.
Me touching it is called getting it.
Right? That's almost getting it. Like, and then you're like, no, never mind. You put your hand on it. That makes it yours. And you're about to purchase it. And then when you take your hand off of it, you're like, not right now.
It's like a dog when he pees on something. That's mine.
That's right.
I pissed on that motorcycle. That's mine.
Well, Champ is Champ's motorcycle too then.
Yeah, oh, that's right. You did tell me he peed all
just
over
just on the tires.
Multiple times?
I didn't see him. Like, I don't watch him
go. It's okay, Champ. I peed on it, too.
That's probably why he peed. No, you're his. That's what's up.
Oh, no.
You belong to him.
I've been his bitch since day one.
I know. Anyways.
Oh,
sorry, Keith. All right, so we're going to take a little bit of a break here. When we come back, which would be in about 30 seconds to a minute, probably.
Actually an hour for us. No.
Yeah, right? It kind of gives us a chance to kind of stretch our legs, kind of do our little yoga exercises. Yes. I'm about to start a yoga class right now. They're all waiting in the living room.
They are.
Yeah, so we're going to go do that real quick, but then it'll be like maybe 30 seconds to a minute for you guys. Okay?
We're gonna wear, what is it, that flash?
Those workout leotard clothes? Things, what are the yoga pants.
The yoga pants.
That's right.
Headbands.
Yeah.
And those long socks, what are they called?
They're called leg warmers.
Leg warmers.
Yeah.
And then we're going to dance to... She's a maniac. See, there's a song for the
on
day.
The floor. Okay, so yeah. So we're going to be doing that. So when we come back, we'll probably be out of breath and a little bit more stretchy.
This is House of Machismo.
Hello, everyone. This is Marty, your host of a wonderful podcast that I like to call House of Machismo. I wanted to take some time here to give you guys a little bit of a break to stretch your legs, read your emails and text messages, all while I ask you to do me just one favor. Tell your friends, family, co-workers, pastors, school chums, carnies, cable repair guys and women, and cable repair trans, I don't want to discriminate or exclude, about House of Machismo. Tell them that there's no other podcast out there like it. And if you don't listen, then the ice caps will melt. It is true. Listening to House of Machismo could actually save the world. That is a fact. Which, if you remember from school, a fact is a statement of information which can be proven true or false. Here's a little history about House of Machismo. We started the podcast way back in 1941, sending hidden messages on the show to our allied forces in World War II. Times were tough for podcasts back then since the internet wasn't around, but we always managed to pull through. You can find us on Spotify, Google Play, and iTunes. And of course, you can find out information about us on our Facebook page. Just search House of Machismo or email us. HOMshow@houseofmachismo.com. Send us a message. Let us know what you think of the show. But do it now, before the earth is doomed.
Welcome back to House of Machismo with Marty Portillo, Luis Salazar, and K-Rod. This is House of Machismo.
Ha Oops. And we're back. Yeah. Maybe next time I should start talking when I raise the volumes on the mic.
Yes. Yes, yeah. Or else they won't hear you.
Yeah, exactly. So I'll remember that. I'm going to write that down.
All they hear is this. Nothing.
Yeah.
While you're over there talking, doing a whole big speech.
I know, right? Okay, so turn mic volume up.
There you go.
When you want to talk.
And I put the sticky note by the monitor.
That's right, yeah. That way I know to turn the mics up when I want to talk. And I want people to hear me.
Yes.
So anyway. So I had something here, Keith. It's from Science 101. I'm going to teach you a little bit about sciencing.
Science rules.
Exactly. And it does. And this is all proven shit.
Good. Because I believe in science.
That's right. You know, and then...
I wasn't good at it, but
here, vamp,
I believe
vamp,
in it.
Vamp.
I believe in science.
That's right.
So is that a thing? Science?
Oh.
I think I just heard Luis in the background.
I know, right? Well, I figured out something else about this thing. They need to be separate audio channels.
Uh-huh.
We'll figure that out for next time.
Right, that's your sticky note.
That's right, yeah. Another one.
Yeah.
Don't run separate audio sources on the same channel. Okay, very good.
The Marty Show.
The Marty Show.
No, it's
the House of Machismo show. That's right.
You got excited there for a second. A
little bit. I'm like, oh boy, can we call it that? No.
I mean, I think you already invested in signs that says House of Machismo.
A lot. Yeah.
And shirts.
And shirts as well. Ooh.
So if y'all guys want any shirts, let us know. We will not get them for you. But you can get them for yourself.
Yeah, they're free.
Are they?
Yeah.
You're giving away shirts?
Yeah.
For the first 100 callers.
That's okay. I didn't give out the number. So we're good. So we're good. And this isn't live anyway. So I could lie and say, oh, we already got our 100 callers.
True.
Thank you for trying. Yeah.
But if you do want a shirt, let us know. Support us out there. They're purple.
I have a friend who works in radio. I have a few friends that work in radio. And when they do these contests, you know how they say our fourth caller or 10th caller will win free tickets to whatever and blah, blah, blah. A lot of that is kind of legit, but some other times it's not. Because I was there when they were giving away tickets. And then I'm like listening to another person that's there says, hey, can my friend win the tickets? They're like, sure, just have them call. So they waited for that friend to call in to say, oh, and then they recorded, oh, you're our something caller and you want our free tickets and blah, blah, blah. He's like, oh, I'm so excited. It was all fake.
Thanks for putting it out there for everybody.
Yeah, so just saying.
Wait, I want tickets.
Oh, I don't even remember what they were tickets to.
Marty, can I win a free shirt if I'm the 10th caller?
Yes.
Okay, cool.
Yes, you can. Yeah, just keep trying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll call 10 times.
Right.
Can they win out? No.
It's like, oh shit, you're the 11th caller. Sorry.
What? Oh, fuck that. I win. Nobody right. calls here, Marty.
Yeah, no. You didn't do your online reservation. So we're going to talk a little bit about some science stuff here. Science 101, which is something on my Facebook, and I like reading what they post and all that. And so they put up 25 myths about the human body debunked.
Mm-hmm.
And these are, what is a myth, Keith? Damn it.
So that's another quarter. I'm about to.
What is a myth, K-Rod?
A myth is something that I believe in.
Mm.
But that's just a myth. That is.
Is a myth true or is it false?
To me, it is. Because I believe in Greek mythology, and that's not a myth to me.
Myth usually has some form of a historical truth to it.
Mm-hmm.
But modern myths are derived from lies.
Lies. You sit in a throne of lies.
Lies. All lies.
Why are you looking into my eyes and saying lies?
Because Luis isn't here. I can't look into his eyes.
Oh.
But I see that dark, dark soul. But anyway.
So, Merc.
That's right.
Merc never lies.
We should call him.
America never
lies. Like, I'm on the track right now. I can't.
Free here, like, all the motors.
He's like, what the fuck are you doing? Calling. He crashes. I'm like, oh, so sorry. Okay, we'll talk to you later. Bye-bye. That's right.
Ambulance. I mean, we're in London, so. Wee-wee-wee.
That's right.
That's not how they sound here.
No, that's not at all how they sound. they're like, wee-wee-wee.
Okay, that's not how they
that's
sound.
That's not how they
that's
sound
like
either.
London.
Yeah.
We're not in London. Are we in London? People don't know.
We're gonna stream live from London pretty soon.
Yes.
Just like my that guy won those tickets on the radio that one time.
Yes.
Just
there
like
you
that.
Go.
Yeah.
Myth.
So, right. So anyway, so basically
25
myths about the human body debunked. Thank you, Science 101. And the number one, I don't think there's any order of importance.
Before we lose any
yes.
followers, you're not going to say all 25 of them.
No, no, okay. No. I just handpicked the ones that I like to.
There you go. Yeah, I can stay tuned. There you go.
Yeah. You're welcome. Some of these are actually kind of interesting. And a lot of people I know have heard these. And so now they'll be able to know that that's not true. And so one of them are juices are not going to detoxify your body. The myth is that juice cleanses, flushes toxins out of your body. Mm-hmm. But that's not true. Did you know that?
No.
So
that's not what the people say that sell the juices.
I know, right? They're like, oh, we're going to cleanse your body. You need to go on an all juice diet.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't cleanse your body. You know, it might give you the runs. You call that cleansing, I guess?
That cleans my stomach.
Yeah. So you already have organs that get rid of toxin chemicals in your body. Your kidneys, your liver, they're all busy taking the crap out of your blood so that you can excrete it while you're downing criminally expensive juices. So it's not necessary to constantly, you know, go on a juice diet and all that. I suppose if you want to lose weight and you're not really
eating,
you know, it's more helpful to lose weight, but it's not really cleansing or cleaning your body by any means. Most people have no idea what toxins they're talking about to remove. Sure, drinking juices can be healthy if it doesn't have loads of added sugar, and it has, so as long as it has fiber. Thin, watery juices are probably doing next to nothing for your body. Hmm. Can you imagine that? Imagine it right now. So anyway. So yeah, juices. You don't need to drink 8 glasses of water a day.
What? Wait, is that the other myth?
Yeah, there's another myth. I'm not going to go in like numbers or anything like that.
No, just say another myth.
Another myth is
you
that
go,
you don't...
just threw it in there.
Right, exactly. I get it now. All right, so yeah, you don't need to drink 8 glasses of water a day.
What?
Yeah, because in 1945, the Food and Nutrition Board recommended people drink at least 2.5 liters of water per day. People took this to heart and started preaching the whole 8 glasses of water per day ideal. But it seems that no one read the recommendation's next line, which is most of this quantity is contained in your prepared food.
Mm.
So the food that you eat already has water in it.
Yeah.
And so you don't need to drink any additional water. Just basically, if you're thirsty, you drink water.
Mm-hmm.
If, say, like you're out there running in the hot sun, you know, you just... you drink water, but only when really the body needs it. Right. Because drinking too much water...
you can drown.
It can be very unhealthy. People actually have died from drinking too much water.
Mm-hmm.
This whole constant, you know, hydrate all day. Remember back in high school, football players would carry around a gallon of water mm-hmm. and they're drinking all day and all that stuff. That's really unnecessary. So as long as people have access to cold or cool water... while they're practicing or playing or something, then people should be fine.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so as long as you're not overexerting yourself too much and that you take breaks mm-hmm. is what's important. And so that's what can get people sick, is the fact that they just keep on going and going and going without taking a break. You got to let the body recover and rest and not overheat. It's not about the lack of water. It's just overworking the body,
mm-hmm.
you see. And even drinking too much water can cause cramps as well.
What?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Okay, so then there's that. this one reminds me of something for a friend here. You don't swallow spiders while sleeping. It's another myth.
We're talking about our friend Ian?
Yeah, but I wasn't going to mention his name.
Ian, hi.
Yeah. He doesn't listen anyway. He's our voiceover guy. Anyway, so yeah, the myth is you swallow 8 spiders a year while sleeping.
The fuck?
Well, that's just not true.
Mm-hmm.
You swallow 9. No. This is probably a relief. You do not swallow 8 spiders a year while sleeping. you probably don't even swallow one unless you want to on purpose, but then that I don't get. To spiders, we are like giant rocks in their landscape. While we're sleeping, we're producing vibrations from breathing, pumping blood, and snoring. Imagine that.
So they're going to be like, oh, freaked out. They ain't gonna.
Yeah, spiders are very attuned to vibrations, so they most likely find sleeping people to be scary. The eight-legged critters probably rarely approach sleeping people. Also, it's highly likely that you would wake up if you felt a spider crawling on your face. If it does happen, it's a random occurrence, not a regular eight per year. So relax, people. Stop.
I wonder who the
out.
Hell came up with it.
Stupid people.
Oh.
have you heard of this one, that your deoxygenated blood, like the blood inside of you is blue, and then when you cut yourself by accident or whatever,
it comes
out red.
Because it hits the air.
Right. That's not true.
That's
your blood is
green.
Yeah, right. Your blood is not blue. Uh-huh. Never was, never has been, and with evolution, probably never will be. Your deoxygenated blood isn't blue. Your eyes are lying to you. All your blood is red. Yeah. All your blood is red. Some of it is bright red, some of it is dark red, depending on its oxygen content. But when you get down to it,
it's red.
It's red. But you aren't blue-blooded like a horseshoe crab. Their blood is actually blue.
A crab.
Ooh, yeah. So why are your veins blue? If you look at them, you can kind of see like a little bluish tint to them. It's how light penetrates your skin. Because we all tend to be a little bit more yellow skin, pale skin. Something about blue light waves, boring. But basically, it's just red. It's not blue. We have more than five senses. What are our five senses, K-Rod?
You almost said my name.
Hey, shut up.
Damn, I've been another quarter.
Yeah.
Hearing, smelling, seeing, tasting, and touching. Seeing, shit. Touching.
Yeah.
Wait, the seventh one, the sixth one, I heard it. I think it's touch, feeling. That's the sixth one.
Well, there's actually more. Well, there's actually more than six.
Oh.
Yeah. While these five senses may be helpful to think about when doing creative writing, they don't tell the whole story. The myth originated with Aristotle. It's a very old dude who's dead.
Okay.
All right. So anyway, who came up with the list, because they are the senses you can obviously see, but we humans sense all kinds of other things. Do you know that?
Hmm.
Yeah. Like, let's see. What does it say here? I don't know how to pronounce this one. We have.
You don't know how to pronounce?
Well, I pronounced it earlier when I was like reading it. But we have what's called proprioception, which is our ability to sense where our body parts are. Okay, so for example, if you ever like catch like a baseball, So you keep your eye on the ball, and then you put your hand up to catch it in your hand, and you just catch it without even looking at it, without having to look at your hand. So you're looking at the ball, and then you look at your hand to catch the ball. You don't need to do that. You can just look at the ball and just put your hand up when you sense where the ball is going to go, and that's where you put your hand up and catch it.
Yeah.
It's just like, bam, snapping of a finger. You have this sensation, this sense that you know where your body parts are. And so you can do things without having to look at it. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Playing with yourself.
No.
I'm using one of my senses.
you dirty whore. So there's that.
That is right.
And another myth is that your fingernails and hair continue to grow after you die. That is a myth.
No.
Yes.
What?
They do not. Okay. After a person dies, their cells stay functioning for differing amount of times. Nerve cells will slowly shut down and die within a few minutes, but the skin cells live for maybe about 12 hours after a person actually dies. Fingernails, however, grow by making new cells that require glucose. Mm-hmm. Yeah, just nod. Just say, mm-hmm. Yeah. And so basically, if you're dead, your body can't supply with no glucose, it's not going to grow. So anyway, so basically, it's pretty much the same with hair. The growing process needs oxygen, and so without it, doesn't grow. The myth originates from the fact that when you die, your skin becomes dehydrated and retracts. It shrinks, kind of like your dick, making your nails.
It's already shrunk.
You're right, and then it gets worse when you die.
Oh shit! It gets way bigger.
Yeah,
fuck.
Yeah. The mortician or medical examiner is like, huh, this guy had a tiny dick.
What if it was the opposite? That will suck.
What?
What if it was the opposite?
Like
when
gets,
I die,
like,
it's like huge.
He gets huge and
like,
big.
Like, fuck is this?
It's like, holy crap, I gotta take pictures of this.
This warlord.
That's
massive.
Right. Anyway, so it can make your nails and hair appear longer than what it actually is.
Mm.
Yeah, but it stayed the same length, just like your dick. Anyway, this is one that's always, that people just don't really believe, no matter how much I tell them. It's like, this is stupid.
You're stupid.
The myth, a person only uses 10% of their brain throughout life.
That's a myth.
We use a lot more than 10% of our brain.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. It's not exactly clear where this myth came from, but it appears to have originated with some scientists in the 1800s, maybe early 1900s.
Well, his brain was at 10%.
At certain moments, you may only use maybe 10% of your brain, like while simply resting and thinking, you know, which is fine.
Mm-hmm.
But during the course of an average day, you will basically use every part of your brain, which, sorry to burst your bubble, but the terrible movie Lucy will never come true. In reality, 10% of our brain cells are neurons, and the rest are called like glial cells, which surround neurons. Okay, so basically the idea is nature would not create something like an organ or our brain, which is an organ, that consumes so much energy and oxygen just to only use 10% of it. It's very inefficient.
Mm-hmm.
So you do like some sort of medical scan, like an MRI of some sort. You can see different parts of your brain firing depending on what kind of images you're seeing, what your thought process is, how whatever it is that you're doing at the time, or whatever it is that you're thinking at the time. Your whole brain. Different parts of it are used for different things in that sense, and so different parts of it will fire up even more. They'll show more activity. They can measure the neurons. Mm-hmm. They fire like electricity, so they can measure the use of it. They can look at it and see that, oh, look, this part is being used. I mean, oh, look, now this part's being used. We use 100% of our brain.
Stupid. Whoever said 10%.
Right, 10%. That's stupid.
But and now I'm sad because I want her to be like Lucy.
Yeah, well,
not at the end if she disappears. And
you want the luscious lips like Scarlett Johansson? Is that what you want?
I want that body.
Yeah.
On me. Sorry.
Yeah, it's okay. So, my friend, who wasn't even part of the conversation, talking to someone else about using 10% of our brain, that's not true. So my friend chimes in. He's like, well, that's in his opinion. And I'm like, it's not an opinion. Uh-huh. You know, yeah. Anyway.
Was he frustrated and mad?
Yeah, but he always is. All right.
Do I know this person?
Yes.
Yes. Oh, here's the mic hit my lip.
This is what happens when you want to sit back and relax.
Ouch, my lip. Kiss it. I mean,
what? That's weird.
That's more than a kiss, Marty.
Sorry, that's weird.
But there's only two times. I'll try anything five times, I told you.
Sugar. This one's for your kids.
Uh-oh.
For your kid.
Please don't tell me sugar does not work up a kid.
Eating sugar makes kids hyper.
That's a myth.
That is a myth.
So my son's just hyper.
And I've been telling people this for years, but they don't believe me.
Holy shit.
Because this is the thing is that, and I understand people's misconception. When they see something with their own eyes and mm-hmm. they see it over and over again, they think, this must be true.
Mm-hmm.
But they don't look at what's more than meets the eye.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So, sugar does not make kids hyper. For the most part, scientific studies have found that sugar has little or no effect on a child's behavior.
Mm-hmm.
There are kids who might be more sensitive to it, like maybe those with attention deficit hyperactivity disorders, but it doesn't have a huge effect on hyper behavior. And so now parents are thinking, oh, well, obviously my kid's not the exception.
Mm-hmm.
But no. As a whole, kids are not exceptional. I think I only met like 3 kids in my life that were exceptional.
Mm-hmm.
And I was impressed. Other than that, they're just kids.
Yeah.
You know?
Holy shit.
Parents are prejudiced against sugar. They believe it causes kids to be hyper, and so that's what they see. They're not thinking about the fact that children often eat sugar are at exciting events. Birthday parties, holidays, which are already making them energetic. But kids are already energetic anyway to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so when you put kids together, what are they doing? They're fucking running around with other kids because yeah. they can play. But while added sugars most likely isn't making the kid, your kid hyper, it still isn't all that healthy.
Mm.
Yeah, so...
True. So now when I hear somebody say, don't give him sugar, he's going to make him have it, like, no, it's not.
No, but a nice protein bar probably would.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know how many kids like protein bars?
Yeah.
No, anyway. Your hair, shave hair, grows back darker and thicker than it was before.
Well, I knew if you shave your hair, it grows back
more. Like more or faster.
Yeah.
That's a myth.
Oh, fuck.
Okay, your hair doesn't grow back thicker or darker or faster. First, you're told to shave your body hair. Then you're told to grow it back even more. Or when it grows back, it'll grow back even worse. Well, science can't fix society's expectations and disgust toward body hair, but it can give you a little peace of mind. When you shave, your hair is not growing back thicker and darker.
Mm-hmm.
So go ahead and shave if you want.
Grows the same.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess it seems like it's thicker because you got used to seeing nothing.
Like my pubic hair.
It's nice and cushiony.
That's right. And I like braiding it and twirling it.
You do that
my
too?
Fingers.
Yeah. I like to pull it.
Oh, not no.
I like the pain.
No, I remember, how old was I? I was like 16,
mm-hmm.
maybe.
Your first pubic hair?
No. No, and I don't know why. I just shaved some of it. Mm-hmm. I don't know why. I just thought, oh, I wonder what it's like.
Mm-hmm.
It was fucking itchy, like
oh,
for weeks,
fuck,
like a couple
I
of weeks.
That.
I'm the like, oh my itch. God, it was like really annoying.
It's like,
and I'm like, oh, won't be doing that anymore.
Yeah. So you haven't shaved since you were 16 years old?
Yeah.
Fuck.
I don't know.
I thought you had a big bulge, but it's just your fro hair.
Just, it's just the hair. Or. I mean, I trim here and there and all that stuff.
Sure.
Make it look pretty.
You know? Little diamond.
That's right. You're not on Facebook.
No.
There's this video that's been going around. Barbershop. It's mm-hmm. not real. It's not real.
Mm-hmm.
Of this barbershop where the barber shaves guys' balls and pubic hair.
Oh,
just
God.
Like they do their mustaches.
Yeah.
And so these dudes are pulling down their pants and they're like... He's like shaving them. He has like the old twirly mustache
oh,
and all that.
Jesus.
And then he does it to match the facial hair
yeah.
and all that.
So it's not real.
It's not real. But it like shows like all these dudes with their pants pulled down, but it's all blurry down here. Like, I like this. It's it makes me feel like young again or something. I don't
what
know.
What the
Anyways.
I gotta see that.
I'll show it to you a little bit later. Oh, no, you mean the video?
Not, no,
the video?
Not yours. The
oh,
video.
Okay. Yes. Never mind. And we'll get
well,
to
that too.
Oh, okay. Okay. So... Humans evolved directly from chimpanzees and monkeys.
I knew that was a myth.
It's a myth. Okay?
Uh-huh. So that's not the evolution.
It is evolution. But it's a myth that we evolved from chimpanzees and monkeys. Humans did not evolve from chimps and monkeys. Yes, evolution is real. It is.
Mm-hmm.
But people have plenty of misconceptions about how it works. All the animals that we see today were results of thousands of years of evolution. The species have all been changing and adapting themselves even today.
Mm-hmm.
So, no, humans did not evolve from chimpanzees and cute little monkeys.
No, not even the cute
ones. Not even the cute ones. And the truth is that we share a common ancestor with other apes. This ancestor lived 7 million years ago, give or take a million or two, after which something changed to make it evolve into two separate species. So we went one way.
They went the other.
And they went the other ways. That's pretty much this is pretty much it.
So who was his ancestor?
But it was like some early ape-like creatures. Yeah, and then we split, and we went one way to the humanoids, and then the apes, monkeys, and all that went off in a different direction, became apes, monkeys, and all that. The new hypothesis... Oh, wait. Ooh, skipping ahead. Mm-hmm. Another one is drinking coffee while drunk will make you sober.
I have not heard of that.
I've heard of that. I've seen it on TV a lot.
That's probably what like somebody's always drunk. Though.
Somebody's drunk. It's like, first of all, if I'm drunk, I'm the last thing I want is coffee.
I know.
Like, here, let's give him some coffee here.
I think that will taste horrible.
Well, it's actually not good either because you know, alcohol is a depressant, so it calms the body down. Actually, mm-hmm. You know, and then you're giving it a stimulant like caffeine, like coffee. Like, doesn't it's not good
for the heart, the heart
and all that stuff. Yeah. So anyway, so it's a myth. Coffee doesn't sober you up. This isn't true, and it's rather dangerous myth. Oh, see, I didn't even read it. the truth is a little more complicated because coffee does do something. After about 2 hours of drinking alcohol, people get sleepy. So if you have coffee at this time, the caffeine makes you more alert and awake. So it can really make you kind of, you know, like extra drunk. Like, oh, I want to fight you.
How do you say, I want to fuck?
Yeah, or that. however, coffee can remove the alcohol's tiredness effect. It does not remove the alcohol's impairment or your cognitive abilities. Okay? Mm. So this can be dangerous because the energy from coffee can make people think that they're sober and ready to drive. Don't do that.
But what about water? Is that a myth?
No. No, because your blood alcohol level is high, so the more clear fluids you drink, water
washes it.
Well, water, especially a Gatorade would help you with the hangovers and stuff. But
squirt, everybody drinks squirt.
But no.
Is that a myth?
Yes.
Everybody that I know drinks a squirt in the morning for a hangover.
Oh, well, I thought you meant to sober you up for that. I mean, I guess it could be okay, but the sugar stuff really doesn't. It's better just to drink water and maybe some Gatorade.
And Menudo. Eat Menudo.
No.
Everybody.
See, that's the thing. It's like when I'm hungover, the last thing I want is something so complicated as Menudo.
Yeah.
It's like it's gross. I mean, like looking at pieces like that. You know? Yeah, exactly.
But that's the food to eat.
I guess it's all the greasiness and stuff. I have no idea. Mm-hmm. But better to fill up on water and Gatorade. Probably even when you go
or
to bed.
Pedialyte.
Probably even when you go to bed. Mm-hmm. So anyways, another one is swallow chewing gum stays in your stomach for 7 years.
No, is that a myth?
That's a myth.
That's how I was scared to swallow gum.
No.
Like when I did, I'm like, oh, I'm going to put that up in 7 years. I do my math, I'll be.
I'm going to be waiting for it.
Yeah.
Gum doesn't stay in your stomach for 7 years.
It stays for 10.
It stays for 20. No. We all heard the tale. Chewing gum stays in your stomach for 7 years and after you swallow it. Well, the first tip that isn't true and to be it's a very specific number. So it's like, why 7 years? Where did that come from? Who knows?
Mm-hmm.
While it's true that your body can't digest gum, the glob just passes through your digestive tract and then back out again.
Mm-hmm.
However, if you were to swallow copious amounts of gum, it could block your intestines.
Well, yeah.
So maybe don't do that. Plus, that makes a pretty bad compelling argument to keep kids from swallowing their gum.
True. I think that's why it started. For the kids.
That's right. It's always about the kids. Always about the kids. Okay. You have to wait 30 minutes between eating and swimming or else your blood will be diverted away from your limbs and toward your stomach, increasing the risk of drowning or cramps.
That's a myth.
That's always been a myth. That's the part that I really don't understand why people believe that you have to wait 30 minutes after eating if you're going to go swimming.
Uh-huh.
While it's true that more blood goes into your stomach, your body has enough to keep everything working after you eat. Additionally, cramps seem to be unrelated to whether you eat or not. During exercise, because you've exercised before, you know, using your muscles, sometimes they cramp up.
Yeah.
And so that can be caused by fatigue, dehydration, or electrolyte imbalance, or a mix of all that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So what does that mean?
Don't work out.
Right. But that also means that if you overexert yourself, that you'd get a cramp. And so what do? You either walk it off, like if it's in your leg, you walk it off, or you kind of stretch it. Mm-hmm. Hard to do when you're in the water, because swimming is exercise. Mm-hmm. And if you overdo it, your muscles can cramp up. And if you're in the water, you die.
Screwed.
No, right, exactly.
Shark comes to get you.
Right. But, so, you cramp up mainly because you're exercising your emotion, not because you ate.
I heard a voice in the back.
Me too. It's scary.
Wow, so that means I can eat and go swim.
Yes.
Oh, so basically this weekend, that's when I'm going to go swim. So that means I can eat. I'm like, ah, look at me, I'm a rebel.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'll get a cramp.
Well, it won't be because you ate. Probably because you didn't stretch or you're dehydrated.
Because I'm fat.
You have electrolyte imbalance or a combination of them all. Or because you're fat.
Yes. And out of shape.
This one's a little sensitive. So regular screening for all cancers and early detection for any cancer will save lives.
Wow.
It's a sensitive topic for a lot of people.
So early. But
early cancer detection screening don't necessarily save lives. This one's pretty surprising. And yes, early detection is important when it comes to cancers like lung cancer, cervical, or colon cancers. And if you're particularly at risk for those, regular screening to look for cancers can save your life. However, this isn't the case for all types of cancers.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So there are a few times when regular screenings don't decrease the number of people dying from particular cancers, like thyroid cancers. Many cancers grow very slowly and will never be harmful.
Mm-hmm.
But early detection of these could lead to some costly, unneeded treatment. So depending on the type of cancer, if it's growing extremely slow, then it's not necessary for treatment.
Mm-hmm.
Because the treatment takes its toll on the body.
Mm-hmm.
And can also poison the body. So when you receive chemo, radiation, even surgery to remove these types of cancers, depending on what it is, sometimes the treatment can do more harm than what the original cancer is there, just depending on what kind it is.
Mm-hmm.
So do you need to treat every single bit and drop of something that's cancerous in your body? Not necessarily.
Mm.
But somebody's going to say, you're not a doctor. You shouldn't be saying that. It's not medical advice. But no. It's just something that you just need to ask questions, you know, when you're at the doctor's office. You know?
That's true.
Yeah. And it also helps to get second opinions,
mm-hmm.
third opinions, or just come to me. Right.
Or Google it.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. And this is the last one. First of all, Keith, I want to ask you, do you know what escape?
Give him a quarter.
Damn it.
You just call my name.
Sorry, K-Rod.
Yay. I think it's like $3.
That's up to $3. I'm going to learn. All right. First of all, K-Rod. Even says K-Rod right here. Should have read it. Do you know what a scapegoat is?
A scapegoat?
Yeah, scapegoat.
Yes.
What's a scapegoat?
As in, like, let's say me and you are doing something, I'm trying to escape. I use you for, like, what's it called? Diversion?
Like a diversion?
Diversion. I use you. You're the scapegoat. So while you do something, okay. I'm going to go over here and escape.
No, there you go.
You're okay, the guinea pig.
That's a version. It's not a guinea pig. But,
I mean, you're yeah.
Okay, so in this fashion, you're putting the blame on something else that actually shouldn't be blamed.
Yes.
Okay, so vaccines cause autism.
Vaccines?
Cause autism.
That I don't think is true. I mean, I never heard of that, but it just sounds...
It's a myth. Mm-hmm. Vaccines do not cause autism. And so the popularity of this myth can be traced back to Andrew Wakefield. He was actually once a doctor,
mm-hmm.
but had this ability to practice medicine revoked. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Wakefield was determined to prove that MMR vaccine caused autism because he was being paid by angry parents to do so.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, he was planning to make money off creating an alternative vaccine. after he published his study, which had fake data. In 1998, scientists studied and perceived relationships between autism and vaccines until they were absolutely sure that vaccines do not cause autism. People still stubbornly believe this despite the overwhelming evidence against it. Mm-hmm. So all this boils down to this one doctor in the late 90s that honestly just made a bunch of shit up
for money.
Exactly. And it caught on. Mm-hmm. And so from since then, there are people that believe that my kid has autism. We don't know how it's caused or where it comes from, but
not from vaccines,
but it wouldn't be from vaccines. They say, well, do you even know what's in your, vaccines and all that? But, you have, I would say millions and millions. There are billions of people that actually take vaccines. And the majority of the population does. And so what are the odds that one of those people would develop autism as a young kid? Pretty well, just on average. Just the average, whatever the odds are that a kid develops autism,
mm-hmm.
or that's their, so what if people just didn't vaccinate? The same amount of kids would still develop autism. Vaccine doesn't really have anything to do with it.
Mm-hmm.
And the thing is that people say, "Well, I did my research," and blah, blah, blah. It's like, no, you really didn't, because you don't know how to do it. Research is different than experimenting.
Mm-hmm.
And so research indicates that you read it, but there are those that actually apply it and that they look into the ingredients and look into the effects of what it does to people, of what it can do to people. There's a difference between that. Reading and holding the test tube, shaking the chemical through mm-hmm. the centrifuge and all that.
Well,
right. I don't think the average parent knows how to do that.
No.
Right.
So, I do.
Right. Nah, I don't. So there's that. It's kind of a little gloss over 25 myths about the human body.
Even though it wasn't 25.
It wasn't 25. I couldn't do all 25. But anyways.
Well, some of them were pretty, wow.
Yeah. And so I'm kind of hoping that maybe you guys would do.
Now I can talk shit to people.
That's right. You can be like, sugar doesn't do nothing. You can tell Laura, look, I'm going to give him this cup of sugar.
And he goes, ah.
Oh, he has diabetes now.
Oh, shit.
It's like crap. But anyways.
I'm like, thanks.
But he's not hyperactive.
So I proved the point.
That's right. So anyway. All right, people. We're going to take a little bit of a break because my throat's tired. And we're going to go finish up our yoga class real quick. They've all been waiting patiently in the other room.
Mm-hmm.
And then we'll be right back.
This is House of Machismo. Bienvenidos a Casa del Machismo con Martín Portillo, Luis Salazar y este menso K-Rod. Estás escuchando a la Casa del Machismo.
Mi madre y yo lo plantamos en el límite del parque.
Workers, please, there'll be time for the frozen pudding wagon later.
You still owe me 10 more Iroquois twists. 10, hi-ya-ya. And 9, hi-ya-ya.
And we're back.
Are we?
Yes, from yoga.
Oh, that's right. Oh, God, I built up a kind of a sweat there.
Especially those goats on top of your back.
I know, right? They're nibbling on my chest, down my back hair.
I still have no clue where you got the goats.
I don't know either. They just kind of came in.
It's I think one of them weird. Pooped on me.
That's what happens when you leave the door open, the backyard, the back door open. Anyways, I got them out, finally.
I never leave my back door open.
Oh, yeah, that's...
From the house, Marty.
Right, from the house, yes. Because you have a hard lesson of things coming in. Yeah. So, there's this new bit that I kind of wanted to premiere. Here's the thing, is that Luis is such a...
Awesome person.
Character. And his views are interesting.
It is.
And so I kind of thought that it doesn't gel well with feminism.
Feminism.
That's right. Yeah. And so it got me to thinking that, well, what if Luis were to be in a monogamous relationship with someone who was a feminist? Like, what exactly would that look like or sound like? And so I decided to write a little bit, and this is sometimes a little bit behind the scenes of what we do here. Sometimes some of this stuff is pre-recorded, and I'll use it a little bit later, but for the most part, we record the show, like, we start at, what, 8, 9:30, and then we just record it all the way through and just do what we do, but sometimes we'll have to pre-record stuff, just depending on people's availability and all that. So we pre-recorded this little bit here, and so we're going to set it up. Where it was one night in...
Alone? No.
It was a dark and stormy night. No, no.
Just like this.
Right. No. It was a night, and Luis had just gotten off work, I think, because he was still in his work clothes. And we're recording this bit, and he came over, but he was going to ride his motorcycle. And I get the... So I got a message from him saying that he was right down the street, like walking down the street from my house. And I thought that's kind of weird. It's like, okay, I thought he was riding his motorcycle. Mm-hmm. And I thought, oh, well, let's go out and meet him. For some reason, he's walking. Maybe he was at a friend's house or, I don't know, out whoring himself out or something. I don't know. And then I got another message saying, hey, I'm here. I'm still waiting for you to open up your garage door. I go, what? So then I meet him out back, and he's on his motorcycle with one of those little miner hats, those little lights that you wear on your head.
Yeah.
That's his light.
that's his headlight.
Headlight. And he's sweating, like, really bad. Like, and he smells like a...
A man.
He smells like a Mexican that has been doing some work.
Uh-huh.
And apparently he had run out of gas halfway between his place and mine, and he had to push his bike all the way way here.
Like, dang, we've been pushing bikes lately.
Yeah, he had to push his bike all the way here. So yeah, so this is where we pick up. So that's why it sounds like Luis is here, but he's really not. He's here in spirit. And he's here digitally.
Hi.
See, he's here digitally. So anyway, so I like to premiere what we like to call the bad couple. But we're just going to go ahead and set this up where right now Luis had just entered the room. And we'll go from there. All right, what time is it? Okay, Luis, we're just going to do something really special for you, and then we're just going to call it a night.
What are we doing?
Well, no, you're just good. We, not
you're
you.
You're listening.
You're going to listen. Yeah. I mean, you can comment.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
It's my birthday.
Yeah.
Oh, happy sex day.
Happy sex day. He's like, it's not Thursday.
All right, continue.
Okay. So anyway, I wrote a little something.
We might fuck up, okay?
Yeah, we might fuck up.
We haven't practiced.
Like poem?
We practiced like once. It's what not a
it?
Poem.
What is it? It looks like question and answer.
It's not.
It's not.
You literally don't have to do anything.
You just sit there.
Yeah.
It looks pretty.
Again, you can comment if you want. That's up to you. But.
Don't be loud.
Yeah, right. Don't be loud. Don't ruin it.
Don't
as, your, as your roommate probably says, don't ruin it by talking.
Nice. He did not deny. He did not deny.
Well, of course, so I have water.
I don't talk.
He doesn't.
I'm the quiet one.
You know what? Surprisingly, I think that he doesn't say anything either.
Wait, hold on. Let's. Do y'all guys burp?
No.
Like when y'all.
Okay.
No, as in like.
No, this is where
I feel like we're okay. When they're on top, I feel like I burp every fucking time. I guess because the.
No, maybe if you just ate, you know, and your food's there.
Because they're like this, and I'm like every fucking time. What am I doing wrong, guys? Am I breathing in my mouth?
I just let the bed and mattress do all the work.
Wait, they're loud.
What happens when you pay for quality?
No. When you have a motor under it and it vibrates it?
Well, sure, with the new Tempur-Pedic mattresses and the Sleep Number, whatever
sleep
thing.
Sleep Number.
Yeah. Oh, actually, they should, why don't they come up with a bed like that?
What? They do.
Oh, they do?
With a what?
I think there was that, way before where it used to like bounce. Like
oh, the vibrating
the
bed?
30s.
Yeah.
Oh, well, like yeah. The, no, I'm talking about like the full motion or something. Like,
fuck, you know when people vomit? Seasick.
Like, oh, she got this started without me. She got started without me again. Oh, well. Okay.
What about the water beds? I got in one of those. I fucking hated it.
Oh, that's kind of weird.
Hey, did you see my end game spoiler?
Wait, you have to remind me. I think I did.
Did you?
Don't ruin it. I haven't seen it. Don't do it.
I posted it on Facebook.
Okay,
it's
good.
A picture of an ass of a girl. So people click on it, and it shows you the little clip, like a 5-second clip, and it's a spoiler.
Oh,
a real bad spoiler. So whoever clicks on it, like, trying to see the... It says GIF, and it's a girl's ass.
You know what's weird? Is that I didn't click on it because I thought it was a trick.
I'm
like, no, I'm not falling
just,
for that.
It just pops up. You see, like, Iron Man and stuff like that, and then it just says spoiler. And then, by the time you see that, it's like, what did you do? No, it ruined the whole movie.
For real?
Yeah.
Okay, don't do it. Well, I'm not going to
see it. Did you already see it?
The movie?
Yeah.
No, but spoilers don't spoil it for me.
No, but I'm saying, have you already
seen it? No, I was going to go Sunday.
We were going to go today because it's $5 Tuesdays.
Oh, cool.
At the Cinemark.
Y'all should have gone.
Yeah, we should have. But then I didn't think of it until
right now.
Yeah. No, until like 8 o'clock. I'm like, oh man, it's a 3-hour movie.
Man, that would have been cool. You could have told me like, hey, Louis, we're going to movies and this and that. It'll be like, oh, fuck, cool. I can use my weed eater. I can make it home and use my weed eater.
You have to push my bike to the cinema.
You don't have to walk.
Yeah, I'm going to have to push the fucking bike home tonight.
Oh,
that's sad. No, I'll probably call my ride. Uber. You got a truck? I need to request a truck.
Can't you push it?
That's what I was doing for the fucking 3 blocks.
I mean, like, you get on it and I just ding, ding, I tappy.
Oh, hell no.
Oh,
okay, I'll run over me.
No, I mean, like, you hold on to the sign.
What?
Can't you do that? Put on neutral and then you hold on to the side of my fucking door and we take it.
Oh, like that? Yeah. As long as you don't swerve to one side and then fucking run me over.
I hit the brakes, wobble.
And yet you're traveling without your wallet.
I know. No ID. No, you just found a dead man.
And you don't have your ID. But they already lock you up. They sent you to Sing Sing, which is a really bad prison in Sing Sing.
In Sing Sing.
In Sing Sing.
What about Guantanamo Bay?
I don't know if that place is still open, is it? Probably.
Hey, but
what?
So what happened with the Endgame?
You want to know?
No.
Wait, when did y'all go?
Oh, because it was 8 o'clock.
Oh.
And I didn't know. Like, I didn't even know what time it started or anything like that. Mm. We used to go to movies, right, on Tuesdays because it's $5 Tuesdays. So.
Yeah, I would have been out about 11, 12.
It's a long fucking time, bro.
Yeah. No. By the time we finish doing the podcast, too. Which we got to discuss that real quick. This will only take a couple of minutes, though. Okay. So, you ready?
Yes.
All right.
Or the way the Mavericks played, guessing Christy Alley's weight. The Dallas Cowboys still were great. Those were the days. And you know you were in trouble when they say that boys are girls and girls are men. Mister, just pick a restroom when you need to use the can. Donald Trump had no command. Bruce Jenner was still a man. Second Amendment was hard to understand. Those were the days.
Welcome to our first installment of The Bad Couple. We join Luis in his very first date with Femina, a woman who caught his interest on Tinder. And now, they're enjoying their time together at one of Luis's old pastime activities. They're at the gun range, exercising their American rights.
Wow, it took a while.
Yeah, it did.
Like,
I'm still getting used to this other program.
Oh, hello there. You must be Luis.
It's Luis. Luis Mirko Salazar.
Ah, yes. Well, I'm Femina. Feminina Ambernanti.
So.
Interesting place to meet for our first date. Here at a gun range? How patriotic.
That's what's up.
What is?
Second Amendment.
Isn't there someplace quiet we can go? Oh, I know. There's a woman in Liberation gathering half-price books in Meeting Room Auxiliary D, way in the back past the restroom at the janitor's office. I believe there would be those little cheesy wheels with gluten-free crackers.
No.
Oh, just like that? You get to decide what we do, huh?
Yes.
Well, I suppose we can make this place work.
Here.
What's this you're handing me? Oh my, it's so big and firm. Wow, there's some weight to this. It's so heavy and long.
Yes.
Wow. And you know how to use it?
Yes.
Oh my god, wow. I need both hands just to hold it. Hey, you, over there.
Hey guys, what's going on?
Oh my, you're Marty from House of Machismo. I always listen to your podcast.
Hey, thanks. It's always great to meet a fan. And as you know, you can catch us on Spotify and YouTube. Say, what's that in your hand?
You want to hold it?
Yeah, I do. Wow, it's so big. You mind if I try it out?
Can he, Lewis?
Yes.
I don't have a lot of lines.
Wow. Sorry, so one of those sound effects snuck up on me. Okay, now, and pause for edit. Wow, cool gun. It's like I'm exercising my Second Amendment right. Now, if you excuse me, there's a woman's liberation gathering at Half Price Books in a meeting room auxiliary D, way in the back past the restroom and the janitor's office I need to get to. It's a great place to meet chicks.
Okay, bye, Marty. He's such a nice guy.
I hear he's a communist.
He just wants all people to be created and treated equal. Is that so hard of a concept to grasp?
Second Amendment, yeah.
So, Lewis, what do you do for a living?
I lay the pipe.
You lay the pipe?
Yes.
Well, I went to Texas Women's University, majoring in chemistry, and with a minor in algebra. And now I teach pre-K. I also work hard to ensure that young men in our society understand to treat a woman like a lady. You know, holding the door for us and to treat us like the delicate flowers we are. And all while letting us exert our independence from our male-dominant society. Let us fight for our own battles. Except when it comes to proofs too much. Then it's okay for men to come in to save us. Oh, and of course, opening jars for us too.
I can tell you practice this, huh? And it was then, at this point, that Luis realized he was out with a feminist. How could he have let this happen? He needed to bail. Commitment issues too long and deep to get into right here at this very moment, but there was something about Feminina he couldn't resist. Was it the light perfume smell? Her delicate hands as she held his 357 Magnum? No, it was something else. Ah, yes. Luis finally realized what it was that grabbed his attention. It was that ass. It was then he knew he could not let her go.
What are you thinking, Luis? You've been silent for so long.
It's because I'm a man. So, stay tuned next time for another installment of The Bad Couple. Thug Life.
Another episode later
or now? Oh, yeah, no, it's going to be another episode. No, I don't have time to write it. Shit. Yeah, I barely had time to write this today or the other day.
That's funny.
That's exactly how you sound.
That's not how I sound.
Yeah, you do.
Yes, it is.
Say well, some. I mean.
Yes, sir. Well, I mean.
That's your.
Here.
Here.
Because I have
nothing, because
I have
nothing to say.
On a talk show. On a talk show.
It's not that hard to do an impression of you. It's actually quite easy.
Just one word.
Yeah. Exactly.
Suck a baby. Yeah, bitch.
I'm a simple man.
That's right.
I'm a simple man with
the Second Amendment. I say we all do a whole show where we just all talk like Luis.
We call it this is the Luis show.
This is the Second Amendment show. This is America.
That's right.
It's the exactly. Middle name he put.
Yeah, American. It's funny because I had a cousin.
Well, that's awesome.
We all have cousins.
I still have him. Oh. But no, he's from Mexico. And when he came over here, back when we were in TJ, I think he came over here for a little while. And it was just funny because everybody's like, is it Mexican Lewis or American Lewis? Because he didn't speak English.
Oh.
So every time, you know, he stayed out here for a few years. So when friends that he got to know, it's like, hey, let's go to Lewis. So I'm like, wait, Mexican Lewis or American Lewis? So I was American Lewis.
Oh, that's awesome.
I've always been American Lewis.
That's right. He's always been American Lewis.
Right.
Oh, and that. Although I probably should have printed the one with the background and all that shit.
I like the other one better.
Yeah.
I can see a trash can there.
You don't want the trash can.
That's symbolic. Well, the only way I like it is if a Mexican jumps through here and falls in there.
In the trash can.
It's me.
Hey, Marty.
No, what's Mexican Lewis doing now?
I'm putting down my American Lewis.
Oh.
Yeah. Oh.
Do you think Mexican Lewis has like his own picture with the with the Mexican flag and with the wall probably on the other side?
With a bunch of cocaine and
right. Smuggling.
Yeah. So anyway, so yeah, this will be a regular kind of series until I get bored and then we'll stop doing
no,
it.
No, but it's pretty fun. I want to know what it sounds like.
It's just like that.
Or what I am assumed.
Wait, is it going to be one of me?
No.
Good.
Fuck yeah.
It'll oh, he really wants one of his. No. Keith, I wouldn't know how to write for you. It'd be all gay.
How? What the? He said,
No, you shouldn't.
Yeah,
like,
it would be. It would be like, hey, what are you guys doing? You want to play with my wiener?
Man, I'll play with your wiener.
When we were trying to rehearse,
I tried 55 times.
We were trying to discover like a voice for it.
Oh, I couldn't.
He's all
do
like,
it. Gay.
It's all like, this was literally Keith's impression of it was, well, I went to Texas Women University majoring in chemistry and minoring in algebra. I'm like, Keith, it's a chick, not a gay dude.
It was funny because I think a response to that, if somebody told me that, I was like, damn, are you ever planning to get a job or what? You know?
Who? What?
No, that.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
The response that somebody's told me, like, oh, I'm majoring in this.
I
would have been like,
I know, right? With that kind of major. Yeah, exactly.
You're planning on never getting a job and living with your parents.
It's like, no, I got a degree in liberal arts, damn it.
Well, goddamn.
Yeah, it's like, it's a phony degree. You know,
a phony.
Calgebra. Calgebra.
What's calgebra? And then what she says, what does she say? I try to teach little boys how to be, like, accept us for this. But then. And then say, what does it say?
Oh, it's right here.
Read that big paragraph.
Yeah, where it says.
Oh, we all, yeah.
Well, that, you know, they should still hold doors for us and all that, treat us like the thing, unless we don't want to, unless we want to be independent, blah, 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 you know. And then she goes back to, you know, but we still want them to hold it. Hold. So it's like, which way do you want it?
I know, right? Well, I mean.
That's a flaw there.
Oh, it
that
is
a feminist.
I thought when I was writing it, I thought of Luis.
No, but that's perfect feminist.
Like, it is. Oh, absolutely.
Tell us what to do. We can do whatever we want. Oh my God, can you help me?
And then, but then I thought, what would make Luis stay with the feminist? And you strike me as an ass person.
Yeah, perfect.
Artie?
I prefer.
See? I embodied. It's like Luis entered my body.
Oh,
and,
God. Okay, man.
And,
who's the gay one now?
And spoke to me.
So he entered you and spoke to you.
That's right. He spoke to me.
No, he said he's a silent one.
That's pretty good. That's a pretty good little.
Oh, well, thank you.
Oh, okay. I'm looking forward to the next one.
Oh, so am I. I don't know what it's going to be about. I don't know where they're going to go on their next date.
You know
date.
What you should do that would be good?
What?
Just tell the people at work, since you work with a lot of women, you know. Like, hey, I'm writing this little stupid skit. You know, like, what do you think? Like,
what are the bullshit stuff do you have to give me?
Yeah, what are feminists like?
So,
but you know, tell them.
Do you guys get special parking? Or yeah. You
know? It's about a fake, you know, super conservative. No, well, it's not conservative. But what is it? A guy from Machismo.
Yeah. He's not conservative. He just wanted to keep his masculinity and hates change.
Mm-hmm. So,
yeah. Exactly.
There's too much.
Second Amendment, motherfuckers.
Yeah.
I
lit
the pipe.
I ran out of gas.
I ran out of gas. I'm walking now.
I know, right?
I'll see you guys later. I got a 1 hour walk.
God, if you would have taken the direct route, he probably would have made it.
What direct?
Well, I don't know. I haven't.
Don't you go straight?
No,
way?
Dude. The last time you gave me a direct route, we did 100 turns.
You wanted to turn left.
Because that's the way you were supposed
to
go.
You
want to
turn left onto that street, then make a right, then make a left.
I never said anything about a right. I just said a left.
But
that was it. There was no mention of a right.
The way it came is the straightest way possible. Just the effects.
Yeah. Oh, where's that thing that you said that you were going to give me?
What thing?
I can't fucking take it when I'm riding a motorcycle. I welded a little dick, man.
What? Another one?
Oh, you saw it?
No, you told us about it.
Oh, that one.
Oh, same one? Oh.
Damn, it was a long time ago, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow, I was going to.
It's going to go right here.
I was going to put it right there.
Right there.
The dick man. The dick pointing at him?
Yeah.
Okay. Like, no. Oh, look, it's just like Luis's. It's like, that's small.
Well, it's actually pretty big on the guy.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, I'm the guy, right? But it is up to scale, right? No,
it's
right
a way. Long bolt.
It's got big. It still gets all rusty and old anyway.
Got some big nuts
there. That's right. Right around the face, too.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Yeah.
Teabag.
Yeah. So anyway, so yeah. So hope you like it. Hope that was great.
I thought it was cool.
Well, awesome. Well, thank you. That makes me want to do more.
You're welcome. I want to correct it. Because
you want to have first rewrites?
No.
Oh. You actually want to get
No, actually.
Or you want to clarify a few things?
Yeah, but they're already been clarified.
Oh, okay.
Feminist.
Yeah.
Feminist.
So. I did like my gun sound effects.
They were cool until you overdid it.
Until you applauded. Until you applauded the second amendment.
Put the wrong damn...
Oh, the applause, because the applause was supposed to be at the end. You know what? It's not even recorded applause. It's an actual studio audience. You know, hey, guys, if you don't mind clapping for me, will you? Oh, okay. No, loud. Okay, thank you. All right. Merkel. Shut up. Yeah. So, anyways. So, yeah, I got to call their Uber because I got to go.
Viva Mexico.
Yeah.
30, right? 30 people.
Right. Well, it's like Uber, whatever, Ultra, whatever they call that.
There's another
one? Damn, I didn't know
there was one. There's like a special Uber that's like a fancier Uber.
I know there's an Uber Black.
Funny. Yeah.
For what? People?
Wow.
I think that's what it was called.
Wow, dude. Keith.
No, I think that's what it's called.
Uber Mexican.
No,
it's like a small Honda, but they can fit like 8 people inside of it.
No, it's like top of the line, expensive ass cars that pick you up.
Ooh, that was funny, wasn't it?
Actually, it was.
It was pretty hilarious there. Whew, sometimes I just crack myself up sometimes.
How did I sound?
You sounded droniness or whatever you want to call it.
Did I sound sexy, though?
No.
Will I pull off a good, sexy girl?
Will
you talk to me if you heard that voice on the phone? Be like, hey, baby.
Maybe.
How you doing?
Yeah, like I just threw up a little bit in my mouth.
And did you swallow it?
No.
Then you're not a swallower.
Oh, no.
I will not talk to you.
All right.
You're a spitter.
Then. That's perfect. Then I'm fine. I'm cool with that.
You should.
That's right. So what you got going on today?
I got to finish packing up to go to San Antonio for the week, my mini vacation.
Mm-hmm.
And then I got a hockey game.
Wait, you're going to go to San Antonio then your hockey game?
That's how I'm finishing packing up to go to San Antonio. That I'm leaving tomorrow.
How long does it take you to pack?
Like 2 minutes.
Oh.
And then when I'm in San Antonio, I'm like, fuck, I forgot this and this and this. I forgot everything.
I forgot Evan. Oh, God. And then he's at home like going, ah! Like
this is
that,
not
like
Home Alone.
Oh, no, it's not? Okay.
It can't be Home Alone because there's a lot of people.
Oh, at home?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Well, that sucks.
Yeah.
So he won't be like pretending to shave in front of the mirror.
Oh, that's bad. No, he did cut his hair one time. Like,
oh, really?
Yeah, with
how
scissors.
Did he have scissors? How did he get the scissors? You're a bad parent.
That's
Let me call CPS right now.
Fucked up. Maybe his cousins. His older cousins left
it
there. And he cut it. And, oh, no. He didn't get scissors. He got, I think, one of his uncles at shaver. And I guess he went on his head and it cut like a little chunk.
Oh. Ooh.
Yeah, it just went.
Well, that's bad.
Yeah, so we had to cut his hair short. This was like 2 years ago, last year.
Well, it doesn't matter. CPS can still write up a report.
Shut up.
I'm just saying. I'm talking about CPS.
Because of you, I'm going to lose my son, you asshole.
Probably. No, because of you, you bad parent.
Fuck you.
It's not me. It's not my fault
that
you're a bad parent.
Whatever. You got a haircut. That's independent.
Oh. Okay, so how long are you going to be...
San Antonio?
In San Antonio for a week.
A week.
And then you don't come back till like late Sunday.
Maybe Monday. Monday, because I'm going to go to work Tuesday afternoon.
Oh, in the afternoon?
Half a day, because the doctor's not back until Tuesday afternoon.
Oh, so they're going to be closed.
No, we're open, but me and the doctor are not going to be there.
Oh, why?
No, we're not going together.
Oh,
she's
going to someplace nice.
Yeah, actually, she is. She's going to Canada.
Oh, wow. That's awesome.
I know. Fuck.
Well, and you're going to where?
San Antonio.
Oh, okay. Antonio. I guess that's the Mexican Canada, eh?
Eh.
Yeah.
I'm going south. She's going north.
God.
Fuck.
Well, you know, Canada's really not that expensive. You know that, right?
I don't have a passport.
Oh. Why not?
Because I don't have one.
Okay.
I do want to, you know what? My dream is to actually go to Canada, go to Rome, all these places.
Mm-hmm.
I just got to make time and money.
Well, I mean, you just put a down payment. You go with the travel agency, you put a down payment on it, and then you just make payments.
So you could do that.
Yeah, they'll set you out a goal, meaning that it has to be paid off by this point.
Uh-huh.
And then you make your payments along the way.
Cool.
Yeah. It's not that hard.
Well, actually, I do
have... this has been in existence for, like, since even before I was born.
I mean, I do have this resort plan that I play. That's what I'm using for San Antonio.
Oh, okay. So it's all inclusive?
Yeah. So that's why we're going. I mean, I wanted to go further, but it was kind of like a short notice, and I don't have a passport, so I couldn't even, like, go anywhere far.
Of course.
So I was like, hey, let's just try this out, you know, San Antonio, see how it goes. And then maybe next year, because in November, I'll be a year there at the job that I went back to, so I'll get my vacation again, you know, a week. So maybe next year, we'll use it and go somewhere out of state or out of the country.
Probably out of state.
Oklahoma.
Yeah, dream small.
Oklahoma.
That's right. Just dream small.
I mean, Canada would be pretty cool.
Actually, it would. I always wanted to go to Canada. I don't like to travel alone. All my friends are losers. I need friends that make money.
I shouldn't be a loser for long.
Right? I just need friends that make money.
I'm making money now. Are you, Keith? Are you?
Well, yeah, but I don't know. We'll see. I mean, it would be nice to take a trip where I have to pay for him, pay for anybody.
Tell you what, you can come with us, but you go your own way.
Well, I don't like San Antonio. I'm San Antonio'd out. I'm
talking about like out of like Canada, so that'd be cool.
Oh,
like you get me, Laura, Evan, and you bring somebody else, and then we all.
I have a friend that can give me half off of. All Hilton hotels. Mm-hmm.
Well, everything by everything owned by
Hilton.
Yes.
Yeah.
But can they get you a resort?
That's so disgusting. You ever think how that sounds to our listeners?
Sexy.
Yeah, that's gross. Well, yeah. We're about ready to wrap the show up, but you know what? Looks like I'm getting a phone call here. Oh, I pick it up.
Is this Blue's Clues?
Who could it be?
I mean, I think if you answer.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
What's up?
Is Luis?
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, what are you doing, buddy?
America.
Oh, that nails it.
Yeah.
Now I know it's Luis.
Second Amendment, bitch.
Now I know it's Luis.
I'm over here.
Oh, wait, Luis. Sorry.
What are you fags up to?
We're talking about you.
What are you guys talking about? You sitting in my spot?
No, I'm not sitting in your spot. I was going to sit in your spot.
I peed on it, marked my territory. It's mine.
I was going to, like, lick your mic. So next time you come.
What do you know about that?
I don't. What do you know? Oh, do you have, like, four kids?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, I have
three.
One.
I don't know. Two. One. Kids. What are you talking about?
Oh, you don't have kids?
I have no kids. Oh, what are you talking about?
That you know of?
No.
So you probably have six, seven, or eight. I can hear you breathing. Are you riding your motorcycle right now?
Second Amendment.
Are you racing?
No. Crashed.
You crashed?
Crashed.
Are you okay?
Yeah.
Do you need me to massage your leg?
I need a ride back.
I'll give you a ride, all right.
I'm on the highway.
You on the highway?
Yeah.
On the highway to hell?
I'm trying to find a ride back.
You want me to go get you?
No. I need your fags to come get me.
My what?
I don't need you fags to come get me.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Can I borrow your truck?
Second Amendment. No.
Why?
Because.
Let me do... I'll feel manly if I drive your truck.
You're not a man. Only men can drive my truck.
So why are you driving?
Because. I'm a man.
Oh, yeah.
Well, Luis, that's not very nice to say about someone. I mean, you know, I mean, we're all men here. We're all men in different ways. It's like...
Yeah.
Who the fuck is that?
That was Marty.
You very well know who it is.
It's like, what the? Oh, Second Amendment.
Okay, I get it. You're all about the Second Amendment. That's okay. I get it. I carry a big gun.
That's right. Sup? Carry a big gun.
Hey, Luis, Luis, don't you call him a commie? Or what do you call him?
Fucking communist.
There you go.
You fucking communist.
It's like, oh my God, I'm not a communist. You don't even know what that actually is.
You're a communist.
Okay, you know what? All right, bye, Luis.
Hey, I was
talk to you next week.
I was a hippie.
That's right. You fucking fag of a hippie. Like,
I got the drugs.
I gotta go. My ride's here.
Oh.
Okay.
What the
fuck? Bye.
Did he just moan at the end?
I think he did.
Because he saw a man.
what a fang. Anyways, so next week it'll just be me and Luis. It's going to be interesting.
Fuck.
And we'll see.
Hopefully I don't...
Can't wait for you to call in.
I know. Shit.
That's going to be awesome.
Show's canceled next week.
I know, right?
don't do it.
Well, we'll probably cancel and just go do something else.
You dicks.
That's right.
We couldn't do that today?
No. Well, we need some material or something. I don't know. We'll take a trip somewhere.
Yay.
We'll go to San Antonio.
Again.
We'll be broadcasting live from the Emily Morgan Hotel from the 12th floor of the Emily Morgan Hotel, looking down on the Alamo.
What?
The Alamo.
The Alamo.
and looking down on everybody there. Not because we're on the 12th floor, but just because that's what we do.
That's what we do.
We just look down on people.
Yes.
We really don't.
The reason I look down because I'm next to Martin.
We're very humble. Down. That's right.
I'm humble. He's not.
He's not very humble. I'm humble. What are you talking about?
He is humble.
I'm extremely humble.
Very humble.
That's right. I'm giving Keith a back massage right now.
He is.
That's right. It's like I'm reaching over right now.
Anyway. With his long ass arms.
Yeah.
But, why are you going low, Marty? No, stay up. Above the waist.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm over here with the yoga people.
Oh.
Well, Keith, I wanted to leave our show with a little something that hopefully you know the lyrics to.
Hopefully. Yeah.
You don't know what it is? God.
I'm
alright.
Sounds like Grease. Do you know what it is? That was Grease Lightning. The other one.
We go together like blah 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 blah. We go together like blah 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 blah. Something with weather. I really don't know the lyrics.
Well, we both say that blah 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 blah
because it makes people think. Oh, boobity goopy
boobies.
I don't know. Dang dang. That's
yeah, but I need the old.
We should have practiced.
We should have.
I thought you loved Grease.
I do love Grease. That's why the other song I knew what it was.
Oh. Doesn't have a really whole lot of selection here.
Yeah, because that was the other one, was it? I got chills.
Which one's that one called?
They multiply it.
Which one's that one?
The one, the first one you just played.
Oh, you're the one that I want?
Yeah. Dingy ding de dong.
I don't know the lyrics. The lyrics aren't on here. You already missed your cue.
I did.
You fucking suck. And then losing control.
It's all supposed to say it right away, huh?
Oh, I don't know. I don't think this one has a backup chorus either. And we're boring people.
Yeah.
So if you don't know the lyrics, I'm just going to kind of stop it.
I got chills.
Oh, God.
Acapella. And they multiply it. And I'm losing control. For your power. You're supplying. Marty is electrifying.
And on that note, I'm going to see you guys next week. It will just be me and Luis, and K-Rod will be in San Antonio.
Down south.
Doing something in San Antonio for the 13th time. Other than that, I am Marty.
And I am K-Rod.
And we want you guys to have an awesome week, and we'll see you guys next time.
Love you guys.
Bye-bye.